Hi, my name is Greg, and in this video, we will be adding an integration to a process model and then configuring success and error paths. This video is part of our integration build series, so be sure to check out the other videos in the playlist linked in the description below. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment to see more videos like this one. Let's get started. Here we have a new process model with a start and end node. Let's add a call integration smart service and configure it. The integration smart service can be used to trigger an integration that modifies data in an external system. If your integration is a Git integration, you can reference the integration in any expression in the process using rule bang. First, I will click into the properties of the smart service and click on setup. Here we can add the integration that we want to call. Simply start typing and it will autofill with suggestions. Once the integration is selected, we will go to the data tab to do further configurations. The data tab determines what data goes into the integration and where the data goes that comes out of the integration. Here we can see the country input, which is the rule input in our Git integration. If we were going to pass a value into the rule input to be used by the integration, we would configure the value parameter, but we will leave it as is for our example. The Outputs tab is used to configure where the data goes that comes out of the integration. By default, integrations have four parameters already defined in the integration results: success, result, error, and connected system. You will notice the data type for each of them. Let's configure each one. Clicking on success, we will set the target location to a variable. In our case, we will click on the plus icon to have a variable created for us. If the integration responds true or false, that value will save here in the success process variable. Let's do the same for the others. If we had additional output requirements, we could create custom outputs and refer to the values in the integration response. But for our example, we will leave it as is. And that's it. Let's hit OK, save and publish, and give it a test. Notice the image we used for our connected system is shown on the smart service. The integration completes, and the process ends. But was the integration successful? Since the node was completed, we know that the node is properly configured, but it doesn't mean the integration itself did an error. For this example, I made a slight change to the integration that would cause the integration to error. And if we look at the process details and look at the variables, we can see the integration errored. But in production, we want our process model to handle errors when they come up. Let's configure a path for when the integration errors. To start, I will add an XOR gateway. If the integration is not successful, it should go on the error path. Otherwise, it'll go on the success path. Let's also add an email smart service to alert a specific audience that there is a problem with the integration. Connect the lines, and here we have our error path. Next, let's configure our XOR gateway to determine when it goes down the error path. We will add a new condition. If the process variable success is true, then go to the end node. Otherwise, go to the email node. In our send email smart service, we would configure the body to display the error message. Using the edit as expression icon in the subject and the body, we can create a custom text output using the fields in the error process variable. While our example is focused on an integration that errors, you can also expand it for integrations that are successful, but do not return the data your process was expecting. If there is a possibility your integration could return different values from what your process is configured for, you would want to incorporate a solution to handle those situations. And that's it. We have added an integration to a process model and configured a success and error path. Be sure to watch the other videos in the series and check out the other great videos in the integrations playlist. Bye for now.